साइंस द लेसन डाइवर्सिटी इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सो डाइवर्सिटी, देर आर वेराइटीज ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑन द अर्थ. सो वी स्टार्टेड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ दीज ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सो एज यू नो, रॉबर्ट विटाकर ही क्लासिफाइड द ऑर्गेनिजम्स अंडर फाइव किंगडम्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज किंगडम मोनेरा, प्रोटिस्टा, माइकोटा, प्लांटे एंड एनिमेलिया. सो इन योर प्रीवियस क्लास थ्री किंगडम्स वी हैव कंप्लीटेड. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फोर्थ वन, दैट इज द किंगडम प्लांटे. किंगडम प्लांटे, ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ अ ग्रीन प्लांट्स, राइट, विच कैन अंडरगो द फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड ऑल, दे ऑल कम्स अंडर द किंगडम प्लांटे. Few are flowering, which are non-flowering. They might be having the seeds. Few are not having the seeds, right? So all these on the earth, whatever the different varieties of the plants we find, it may be the herbs, the shrubs, or the trees. So all varieties comes under the kingdom plantae. So these kingdom plantae are eukaryotes. Multicellular eukaryotes and can undergo photosynthesis, or you can say these are autotrophs, right? And here we don't find any vascular bundles. No vascular bundles. Means what happens, students? Xylem and phloem we don't find in case of the algae. As these are not having the root, stem, leaf and all, there is no transportation system. Passing of the food to other part of the plant body, absorbing the water, nothing doing. These are the aquatic one and the just thallus we find. The plant body is called as the thallus. So easily we can, there is no part of the transportation, so we can say as no vascular bundles. Okay? Examples to the this one algae like Eulothrix. Examples. Eulothrix, Spirogyra, Chera. So many examples will come, students. Few examples like Eulothrix, Spirogyra, Chera, Alva. Don't make it Alva. It is ULVA. Alva. Right? So like this, so many examples we find in the division Thallophyta are called algae. Next division, that is division Bryophyta. So few things are common, students. As I said, the kingdom plant itself is autotrophic. So few general points what you can write. These are multicellular autotrophs. Okay? Where you find? We find bryophytes in water as well as on the land. That is what these are called as amphibians of the plant kingdom. Amphibians of the plant kingdom. Hope you know the meaning of amphibians. The same organisms which you find on the land as well as in the water. So even these plants, you can get it on the land. Where we find on the land? Wherever the moist place is there, during rainy season especially, we find that algae and bryophytes. Okay? So if the water is standing, if there is a wet wall, wet rocks are there, on that you find. On the tree trunk during the rainy season. Right, students? So, in the water as well as on the land, that is what these are called as amphibians of the plant kingdom. If you see the structure of bryophytes, the body cannot be differentiated as a root, stem, leaf in some of the members. In some of the members, it looks like a very small plant. Right? But exactly there is no root, stem and leaf, students. It looks but not. Okay, so few bryophyte members are having root-like structures. The root-like structures are called rhizoids. What do you mean by rhizoids? Root-like means they will perform the function of the root, means absorbing the water and all, but not exactly the true roots. So you have to explain as root-like structures called rhizoids are present in case of bryophytes. Okay. We don't find vascular bundles. No vascular bundle. Xylem phloem we don't find because plant body is very small. There is no need of transportation of food and water. Right? So we don't find the vascular bundles. Right? Examples to the bryophytes. And one more thing, students, reproduction. Asexual type of reproduction. Even in case of algae also same. Asexual type of reproduction takes place. Examples like Rickettsia, be careful with all these spellings and all students. Rickettsia, Marchantia, okay, Funeria, take down. These are all the examples to the kingdom. Sorry, division Bryophyta. And one more thing, students, these are also called as newer words. These are also called as liverworts. like this, the ribbon has spreaded on the floor, like that the body is. Here you find the rhizoids. Okay, because of this structure, they call it as, it resembles like a liver itself. So this group is also called as the liverworts. Liverworts, amphibians of the plant kingdom. Note down the points, friends. Yes.
Pteridophytes.
sperm's word is of the combination of two words. What are all those? Gymeno. The meaning of gymeno means naked. Sperma means the seeds. If you combine, you can say these are naked seeded plants. See, students, imagine a mango, right? So mango, where you find the seed? Inside the fruit. How the? So here what happens, the seed is not covered with the fruit. It is exposed. So it is called as naked seeded plants. Seeds are not covered with the fruits, right? So in this gymnosperms, these are the terrestrial, multicellular, aquatic, and many gymnosperms are perennial, evergreen, and woody. Means trees also you find, and they can grow meters together of the height. And highest lifespan these gymnosperms are having, right? And gymnosperms are having well developed muscular bundles, right, students? And coming to the reproduction. Reproduction takes place with the help of the structure called cones. So in the plant body, you find cone type of the structures you find. So with the help of the cones, they can undergo the reproduction. Okay? And male cone, female cone, like that we find. So with the help of the cones, we find the reproduction in case of gymnosperms. That is one special feature in this division. Examples like cycas, pinus, neatum. See the spelling of neatum, students? Cycas, pinus, neatum, G is silent. So these are all few examples to their division, gymnosperms. So longest trees, means you can say tallest trees, with the highest lifespan, all comes under the gymnosperms. What is the special feature? The seeds are not covered with anything. So these are naked seeded plants. Right? So these are all the features of the division gymnosperms. Division angiosperms. Again, like gymnosperms, angiosperm is also one of the Greek word with a combination of two words. Angio means covered. Sperma means seeds. Means what you can say? The seeds are covered with the fruits. In case of angiosperms, the seeds are covered with the fruits. Right? Such a group of plants comes under angiosperms. And these are the flowering plants. These are the flowering plants. Till this division, we did not use the word flowering. It may be thallophyte, bryophyte, pteridophyte, or gymnosperms. You don't find the flowers. So where you find the flowers? In case of angiosperms, so these are the flowering plants. It may be the herbs, shrubs, or trees. If the flower it is bearing, it comes under the angiosperms. Keep it in the mind, students. So a few things are common: multicellular, autotrophs. Okay? Now, how the reproduction takes place? The reproduction takes place with the help of the seeds. Because seeds are present, seeds are covered in the fruits, and with the help of the seeds, you find the reproduction. Right? Like this, we find the characteristics of the angiosperms. And the seeds, when they will start germinating, you might have observed, it will be bearing the seed leaf. Two leaves will start on both the sides. Seed leaves you might have seen. And those seed leaves are called cotyledons. Those are called cotyledons. The cotyledon may be single the dipod. Monocotyledonous and dicotyledonous. Monocotyledonous plants are called monopods. Dicotyledonous plants are called as the dipods. Still, if you want to make it simple, students, monopod examples like wheat, rice, grass. You have seen. Take the wheat. Can you make it into two equal parts? No, you can't do it. So that is monocotyledon, single cotyledon. Rice. Can you make it into two equal parts? On longitudinal or this one cross section? No, we can't do anything. It will become powder. So it is a monocotyledonous. How can you identify dipod? Groundnut. Groundnuts you have seen, or peanut or groundnut. So can you make it into two equal parts? Yes, we can do. So that all comes under dipod. Groundnut, green gram, black gram. Whichever you can make it into two equal parts. So those comes under the dipod plants. Right? Still more characteristics comes to students about monopod and dipod. Kingdom Plantae. Okay? So next class we will begin with the kingdom Animalia. Okay, take your today's home assignment. Differentiate between monopods and dipods. Differentiate between monopods and dipods. Second question. Which kingdom is called as amphibians of the plant kingdom? Not kingdom, which division of the plant kingdom is called amphibians of the plant kingdom? Okay, remaining all read students, as you have the textbook now. So go through the textbook, remaining we will discuss in our next class, right? Thank you, have a good day.